the low pumping jumping jack. Wow, that's what's written in my notes. So, what is it? So first of all, we're going to get down low. We're going to get down low in the water, and we're going to jump out and in. Now this is slow motion, out and in, and out and in. So what's it look like when I go at full tempo? Push, push, in, out, out, in, out, out, in, out, out, in. Notice my elbows up high, and I'm basically pushing my arms down. So, let's start from the bottom up, on toes. You're definitely bouncing your toes. So in and out, you're on your toes. You're not pushing your heels down. You could push your heels down. I don't think I like it as much though. You could push your heels down. I feel like I've got more bounce when I'm on my toes. Now, let's clarify something here. People have said to me, oh, you shouldn't do stuff on your toes in the pool because your calves will cramp. Really? Where did you get that piece of information from? People cramp for all sorts of reasons. Hell, I got cramped sleeping in my bed the other day and I wasn't bouncing on my toes doing that. So cramp and why people get cramps are varied, and there's no actual scientific proof specifically about how they happen or why they happen. But you can't now correlate that to being in the water. Also, when you're in the water, I don't weigh anything compared to what I'm doing on land. So I'm not going to work my calves excessively. Now, for some reason, it just feels better to be on your toes because you've got that elastic effect through the body as you work your fascial line. So I think I like this on my toes better. Next thing, you're keeping your shoulders underneath the water. You can tell how much force I'm pushing down by the way my head is bobbing up and down. So because, you know, you're on land, you're looking for different signs of what is an effective movement. If you're seeing this, trust me, they're not working that hard. They might be working at the right speed, but they're not working that hard. And my knees are not lifting up that high. So you want the feet to really lift up off the bottom of the pool. And that will also encourage you to move your arms more. So you can either say to your clients, lift your feet up off the bottom of the pool that much, or you can say, lift your elbows up and really push down with your hands. Either cue or both is going to be really effective at getting them pushing out and in well. Fingers stay open, but they act like a plunger. So it's just a downward motion, not turning your hands. You don't have the time to do that. And what's this good for? Well, it's great for bone mass because there's a bit of impact, but it's not hard impact. You're definitely pushing off. There's definitely impact involved. Also great for cardio. So getting people to do something with cardio. I also like mixing up doing slow and fast stuff. So the fast stuff is working on fast twitch, nervous system, and getting that really active. And other than that, I think it's a great exercise. And that's this week's activity. To demonstrate the double pumping jumping jack, it's best to do that so you're seated down or if you've got an apple frame. So, if you're going to do it seated, which is actually probably the easiest way to demonstrate this, you're down and you're pushing down. So making sure that you spread your fingers open and you're lifting the elbows up. So it's not a very difficult exercise to demonstrate. The only thing that I find really challenging with this though, when I'm teaching some pool deck, is that they don't get that they've got to lift their feet up high. And that's why using an aqua frame, going in, they get a little bit more of an understanding about how much you want them to lift their legs up and down. So it is important that they know that they've got to come down in the water and then get the legs gone. So this is how I would teach it. All right, drop your shoulders down, lift your legs up, jump in, jump out, arms in, arms out. I want to see your elbows. So elbows up high. And indicating where you want the elbows to be will be very valuable, because what often participants do is they pat the water with their hands rather than realizing that they've got to use their entire upper body to create that motion with their hands. Encourage them to spread their fingers wide, get the palms open wide, and then away you go. So not a difficult exercise to demonstrate, but it is handy
get to have the apple brain, and that's this week's apple tip.